In this video, we'll introduce the hierarchy processor transformation, which is available with an elastic mapping in Cloud Data Integration Elastic. This demo will show you how to use the hierarchy processor transformation to convert one hierarchical input source into two relational output target files. Let's say we have a JSON file with customer and order data, and we want to separate the data, one file for customer data and the other file for order data. We want to convert the source customer order file, which includes structs and arrays, into two flattened output files. We have an elastic mapping that contains the source transformation with the JSON input file. Now we will configure the hierarchy processor transformation. To make it easier to see all the fields we're working with, we'll expand the properties panel below. Let's take a look at the input. We'll use the add link to define the hierarchy processor transformation. We can generate unique keys if needed for the transformation. Notice that we don't have any output defined yet. We can add each output field manually if we want to. Let's see how we can define the two output files quickly. We'll use the top-level group input. Then select Add All Descendants. The input group contains sibling arrays, so Add All Descendants will create a separate relational output group for each array. Let's see what adding all descendants did for us. All the customers' descendant child fields are now defined in the customer output group. And all the orders descendants child fields were defined into a separate order output group. We can rename the output groups. Let's see what else the add did for us. It assigned our data source to customer. And we can optionally create a filter for the data. Had we created a filter, this icon would indicate it. The add also created an expression for each field. If we want to update an expression, we can do that too. We can use the input fields or built-in functions in the expression, and of course, validate it. So to recap, we started with a hierarchical source file, and now we have defined two flattened target files. Let's connect the output, validate, and save the mapping. Now that the mapping is ready to run, we'll create a mapping task. These are the resulting example relational output files after running the hierarchy processor transformation mapping. In this video, we saw an overview of the hierarchy processor transformation and demonstrated how to convert hierarchical inputs into relational output in Cloud Data Integration Elastic. For more information, check out the documentation for the hierarchy processor transformation in the Data Integration Help. Visit our community and support hubs, or check out our website.